Hello everyone, today we'll discuss income and substitution effects, and we'll focus on normal goods as well as inferior goods. Let's assume these are Maya's preferences, and here is her budget constraint. Now let's suppose that there's a price fall and the price of movies falls to $4. So this is a new budget constraint, and she moves to the new welfare maximizing point, point J. So this move from point C to point J is the price effect. She seems to consume more movies from 2 to 6, and she consumes less of pop from 6 to 4. This is your price effect. What we're going to do is we're going to divide up this price effect into substitution effect and income effect. So in order to reach from point C to point J, we're going to make another stop. Let's start with the substitution effect. Well, when the price for movies falls, movies become relatively cheaper as compared to pop, right? And since movies are now cheaper, Maya has more income because she's spending less on her movies. There's more income left over that she can now spend either on movies or on pop. What we're going to do to isolate the substitution effect is to take away the increase in income that occurs as a result of this price fall. Now, when we take away the income that she has gained, we are basically taking her to the original indifference curve. Right? When you take away that income, that budget constraint shifts parallelly down. Right? So it's a parallel shift in the budget constraint, and you move to a point on the old indifference curve, I1. Right? So this point C to K is really the substitution effect. As the relative price of movies fall, she ends up buying more of movies, which is relatively cheaper now, and less of pop, which is more expensive. To separate out the income effect, we move from point K and we give Maya back all the income increase that she gained from the price drop in movies, and such that she now moves to the new indifference curve I2. So look at this budget constraint. This is a budget constraint that is going to shift to give her that increase in income. So it's a parallel shift. So we give back the income that we had taken away earlier, such that she is now on the new indifference curve. And when you give back the income that you took from her, she moves from point K to point J. In the case of a normal good, this income effect is positive. When you give Maya back the income, she ends up consuming more of, this is a move from K to J, right? So she ends up consuming more of movies, 4 to 6, and she ends up consuming more of pop as well. This is from 3 to 4. So move from K to J is purely due to an increase in income that resulted from a price fall for Maya. For in case of a normal good, the substitution effect is reinforced by the income effect. So price effect, which is a move from C to J, is C to K, point K to J.